fun to be back. And I just wrote a little something down, keep me on track, 4.5 minutes, I believe. Okay, so last year I spoke at the same convocation and I described a time where I found myself in a place that felt unfamiliar. I was at my alma mater for an annual work retreat surrounded by brilliant, successful, and incredible people. Last week, I went to the same annual retreat, and while my visit before was colored by my perception of the participants, this time my feelings were drawn not from perception, but from their personal and professional accomplishments. Once again, those feelings of deficiency emerged. Just like last year, I felt that I was in a place that I did not deserve to be. I wondered why I had been chosen. This year, I again felt uncertain as I headed 3,000 miles away from home to the crisp fall weather of New Haven, Connecticut. How can I stack up to this incredible group with whom I was about to meet with again? As I drove up to New Haven from New York with a fellow board member, I found that I was not alone in my fears. She too shared that she felt that it was a mistake that she was selected for this honor. It caught me off guard. Here is this brilliant woman, and she also felt inadequate. You know, we put so many ideas in our head that place limits upon us, not knowing that others are just as fearful. Remember that fear at times can actually mean false evidence appearing real. It's a feeling. While there are real tangible things to be afraid of, fear of being great should never be one of them. Achieving your personal greatness is your responsibility. And because you are here itself, you are already taking the next step in your own journey towards greatness, writing the next chapter in your story. Many of you may have heard the famous quote by Marianne Williamson. She said, "Our deepest fear is not that we are inadequate. Our deepest fear is that we are powerful beyond measure. It is our light, not our darkness, that most frightens us." We ask ourselves, who am I to be brilliant, gorgeous, talented, and fabulous? Actually, who are you not to be? As we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. End quote. This is your life. You are in control. Many of us have had crazy stories about our childhoods and have faced many challenges. But no matter what, it's important that you always remember your gifts. These gifts will serve as your power. It's up to you to chart your path. Everyone in this room is powerful, but it's how you decide to use that power that will separate you from others. You must decide who you will become. Again, there are many things to be afraid of, but allowing your greatness to shine shall not be one of them. This is the most important lesson that I learned while at South. I had been selling myself short. I wanted to be great, but I was afraid. That was until I came here. I was told with absolute certainty that I was great, and it was my responsibility to allow my greatness to shine. I have all of these opportunities, and it is my choice and my choice alone to take advantage of them. You have chosen to be here, or maybe someone made you, and now is your time to take credit for that and say you want to be here. So from now on, only you can choose to put your fears aside and achieve. Remember, fear is not always real. It's sometimes just our reaction to the unknown. Do not allow fear to keep you from doing. My son, who's a huge Star Wars fan, is always quoting Yoda, which I don't really know what Yoda is talking about with his background as Yoda. Do or do not. There is no try. What does that mean? Not really sure, but I'm going to go with the wise Yoda was saying, instead of saying, "I will try," we need to change that and say, "I will do." There is never a time more than right now that South's model rings true. Start here, go anywhere. And ladies and gentlemen, that is exactly what it means. I am someone that grew up in a chaotic world. I was a teen parent, I graduated from South Seattle, and went on to Yale University. And now I am currently working on my second master's degree. I am unable to find any logical reason why I should be where I am, but for the fact that others believed in me, the people at South believed in and encouraged me. The lessons I learned in South were invaluable. While here, I learned to accept my gifts, take charge of my future. You are here. Know your strength. Know your power and rejoice in it. Remember, as Ms. Williamson says, as we are liberated from our own fear, our presence automatically liberates others. I charge you with this. Accept your power so that others may accept theirs. Thank you.